5, we're running wild with the new Korean film review, Running Wild, from 2006. This is a crime noir film. Something about the poster just really, you know, caught my attention. I've always wanted to see this one. It looked very stylistic. It's got some actors that I like in it, especially Yoo Ji-tae. It's a crime noir film starring Kwon Sang-woo, and he plays a character named Do-young, who's this detective really hardened by a sort of ineffective, overly bureaucratic system, and who really longs for justice at all costs, and sometimes all of this paperwork can get in the way. This guy hates two things in the world: cockroaches and thugs. So, he's a gritty cop. In contrast to him, we have Yoo Ji-tae. You guys might know him probably from his most famous worldwide role in Old Boy. So, amazing actor, we all know. Plays a character named Jin-woo. And he's this by-the-book career prosecutor that puts his work above all else. He's slow, he's methodical, he's someone who wants all documents in line before he makes a big move. So with Do-young, he's on this sort of quest for personal vengeance. I don't want to give any plot spoilers away. You'll find out when you watch the movie. With him on his quest for personal vengeance, and Jin-woo looking to make a career-defining bust, these two guys find themselves teaming up to bring down a very large crime syndicate in Seoul that has recently stepped its foot in the door into politics. So this film is from 2006, and if you're experienced with watching Korean films, you've seen this idea should sound very familiar. Prosecutor, we've got the police department and this, you know, organized crime. So there's a little trifecta here, you know, with sort of blurred moral compasses on all of the characters. So on the surface, this is, you know, your cops and robbers type movie. We got some gangster action thrown in there. It's very stylistic, but this is basically just another one of those movies that's about frustration with the system, largely political and judicial system that is seen as corrupt and inefficient at almost every level. And so these two main characters in this movie, Jin-woo and Do-young, who are, you know, the detective and the prosecutor, these characters basically represent the extreme ends of this perceived inefficiency of the system. So with Do-young, just by looking at him, you can tell that he's a character that's really been beaten down by the system. He's got this long, scruffy hair. He wears kind of the same dirty clothes all the time. He's got what appears to be like an extra layer of bronzer from his makeup or something like that. It looks a little orangey to me. Kind of weird, let's be honest. But, you know, it's supposed to, I think, make him look a little bit more hardened. So this character, he's a hardworking detective who can barely scrape together enough cash to pay for his dying mother's medical expenses. So that's weighing on his mind all the time. He's hot-headed and he's overly eager to catch criminals, even if that means planting evidence or beating the life out of somebody. Jin-woo on the other end, he's clean-cut, he's always in a suit. He's the keeper of order, even in when mayhem breaks out. Someone's done him dirty in the past, and in a previous case, and he's decided to take his work very personally, even if that means sacrificing his marriage. That's sort of the dynamic set up with the main characters. Kwon Sang-woo plays our main character of Do-young, and we're really supposed to feel kind of sympathy for him. He's had a hard time. He's supposed to have a lot of rage built up inside of him, but for me, when I watched this movie, I didn't really see a man in rage. His performance was a little bit too overacted for me, and it came off a lot of times as sort of a child throwing a temper tantrum. It's just got a real annoying after a while, because he loses his cool and he gets crazy in almost every scene. And he tries to punch the wall. I get what they're going for, just a real character who is just enraged and angry at everything in the system, but I don't really feel like this actor could pull it off in this movie. So the style of filming and editing that was employed in this film really had me scratching my head at times. At some points it feels like the film's going for this sort of comic booky 70s action film throwback vibe with these quick Shaw Brothers style zoom ins on the characters' eyes as they say, "I'm gonna kill you." And then the film shifts sort of towards this more music video style editing, with like a lot of split screen, multi-picture shots, almost looking like a page of a comic book again. And then it starts breaking a lot of established editing rules, like the 180 degree rule, where the camera sort of will just flip 180 degrees and the characters whoosh, change places on screen. I don't know if it was doing this to be clever or if it was going for dramatic effect, but in the end, it just felt awkward. This style of filming that went in this, it almost felt a little too experimental, a little too showy at times, and it didn't really stick to one vibe. The dialogue in this movie is also very awkward at times. They use a lot of idioms in this script that try to sound really dramatic and descriptive, but it just comes off as awkward and sort of cringy. And I'm gonna say almost every interaction that the characters have in this movie, where they set up the shot, and we start the conversation, we get some details about the plot, it has the same predictable shift. It'll either go to sappy melodramatic mode, or one of the characters will completely lose their shit and start punching the wall or look for someone's face to punch. It gets very predictable and just repetitive, and nothing is happening. They're not solving anything. It's just the same thing over and over. Running Wild is a long movie. It's 2 hours and 24 minutes, and I feel like the story didn't actually start until the 50 or so minute mark, which is pretty crazy if you think about it. They tried to do this big character setup, and really nothing happened. So it started at the 50 minute mark. They could have told us the backstory through like one or two lines. And even more surprising, there's like very little character development until about the 1 hour 25 minute mark. Okay, but it's way too late by then. Action scenes in this movie are very stylized, but they sort of feel like the climax of like a 30 minute episode from a 70s like cops and robbers type TV show, every single one. The music is also very heavy-handed. This movie does have some awesome on-location photography, whether it's from the countryside or from the rooftops of these skyscrapers within the city. Occasionally, this film looks very, very good. I just wish there was a lot more substance to go along with it. There's also way too many henchmen in this movie that really detract from our main villain, who's this sort of king of the underworld type who's just gotten out of prison. Seems like he's kind of going clean. He's trying to get into politics and philanthropy, sort of pulling a Kingpin from Daredevil season one, where the cops, they're like, we can't really go at him because he's got this kind of good boy image now. All of that sort of gets tossed aside for more this family drama that focuses around Do-young's character, and the movie starts making very general statements about Korea's corrupt judicial state of affairs. So we sort of lost the whole like impetus for going after this guy. And so when he comes back at the end for these big dramatic scenes, you're like, oh, him again? Oh, kind of forgot about him. Yeah, overall, this movie was a real chore for me to sit through. And it tries to do a little bit too much as a film. It has a real epic vision in mind. But by the end of its, like I said, 2 hour and 24 minute runtime, the movie really fails to do much of anything. So I'm gonna have to rate this movie a 4 out of 10, definite misfired attempt at being a real sweeping tale of crime and revenge. So what are your guys' thoughts on this movie if you did see it? I know it's a bit of an oldie, but you could probably find it somewhere to watch. It's 2018 now, so we've got a lot of different ways to watch it. I actually watched it on the Korean version of Netflix, so don't think that's available to everybody worldwide, but you can definitely track down a copy, or you probably, if you've seen it in the past. Let me know your thoughts on this movie. I'm real curious on other people's response to the running time, and just how you responded to the main character and the overall message of this movie. So that's gonna be it for this one. If you do want to see more videos like this, you can check out the playlist section. I'm trying to build up a little bit more Korean film reviews you can check out. So we got some other big movies, new movies coming up this week, so stay tuned for that. Until next time, this is Tyler from The Movie Beat. Keep watching movies.